following up our tips for better portraits, today's tips are 5 tips for better portrait lighting. And a few of these are actually different types of lighting. Try them out. Tip number 1 is to do split lighting. So this is where you put your light source about 90 degrees to the side of your subject. So it's very dramatic and it creates lots of shadows, especially if the rest of the room or wherever you are is relatively dark, and it can create some great looks. But this, it tends to be a little bit more of a masculine look, so sometimes it doesn't look as good on women. So just keep that in mind. Tip number 2 is to try to make sure that you have an eye light or a catch light. This is something where you actually see the light source in your subject's eyes. It's a little glint in their eye, and it makes their eyes pop rather than being a little bit dull and lifeless. So you can see in these images that there's the light source in their actual eye reflecting, and it makes them pop. Tip number 3 is to try Rembrandt lighting. So this is a 45 degree angle from above light source, and it creates a trapped triangle on one cheek. And this is what the artist Rembrandt used to do in his paintings. And it's still a very interesting and semi-dramatic type of lighting. Tip number 4 is to use backlighting. So we've seen a lot of different images of portraits, and by adding a little bit of backlighting or rim lighting or a hair light, it's all one in the same, it really separates your subject from the background. If your backlight is, say, for example, the sun or something very, very powerful, you may need to fill the front of your subject's face with a flash. And this can actually create some very cool images. So it's one of the times that we suggest using your flash if the sun or a major light source is right behind your subject's head. But remember, you have to position your subject and the camera so that the light source is actually behind their head, being blocked from view, and not just over their shoulder, because then you're going to have a big, bright, overexposed sun or light in the top right or left corner of your image. Really make sure that the subject is blocking that light source. Tip number 5 is to get outside. So if you're outside and you're trying to figure out the best lighting, you might have to put your subject in the shade. Sometimes having the sun beaming directly on your subject isn't going to be the most pleasant lighting. So stick them in the shade, but make sure that the background isn't too sunny, it isn't too bright, because if your subject is in the shade and you're exposing properly to your subject and it's very sunny in the background will then end up being overexposed. And typically you don't want much overexposure in your background, and it will look a little strange if it's just your subject that is exposed properly and then just a very overexposed background. So try to position your subject and the camera so that both your subject and the background are relatively shady. And those are 5 tips for improving the lighting of your portraits.